In this movie, we're gonna study a theory model developed by Fur and Schmidt. This model is quite famous for economists who study behavioral economics. So let's think about this model together in this movie. This model is called FS model of inequity aversion. So, as the model's name tells you, this model considers an individual who cares about inequality. As you know from what you learned from your undergrad program, in economics, we usually assume individuals don't care about inequality. So when we say inequality, so if someone cares about inequality, what does it mean? So it means that individual cares about his payoff and at the same time others' payoff as well. Because when we say inequality, we are thinking about the difference between what I have and what you have. So in this way, when we think about inequality, the individual we are considering is thinking about comparing my payoff and your payoff, and perhaps he gets angry if his payoff is lower than others' payoff. But this is not what standard theory predicts. So as you all know, in standard economic theory, we usually assume selfish individuals and selfish individual means this individual cares about his own payoff. He doesn't care about others' payoff. So suppose I have very small, let's say I have payoff, so I have $10, others have, I don't know, $1,000. The selfish individual doesn't care about this kind of information. Selfish individual obtains payoff from what he has, $10. But it seems that as economists study behavioral economics through many kinds of experiment, it seems that in reality, individuals do care about others' payoff, and they often compare their payoff with others. And they do care about inequality among people. So here in this movie, we're gonna study FS model of inequality aversion, and we're gonna try to explain our experimental findings using this model. It turns out that this model can explain many experimental findings that cannot be explained by standard economic theories. So let's start with basic model. Let's think about individual I's. Let's think about individual I's utility function or payoff function. Standard theory assumes that his individual I's payoff or utility depends on his own resources or money. So here, XI represents individual I's consumption or resources or money. So here XI represents what individual I has. So this is a typical assumption in standard theory. But FS assume, so FS assume individual I's utility function or payoff depends on entire distribution of resources. So here X is a vector, so for example, x1, x2, xn. So here x1 is resources that individual 1 has, and x2 is resources that individual 2 has, and so on. So FS basically assumes that entire distribution of resources determines individual I's utility. So in particular, they assume there are three components in individual I's utility function. First, this is traditional component. So individual I's utility depends on individual I's resource or consumption. So traditional theory ends here, but now FS adds two terms here. First term, so we're gonna add two terms. So we're gonna add two terms here, and as you can see, we subtract these two terms. And these two terms are related to inequality. Especially first term is about envy, and second term is about compassion. So here first term, envy refers to situation where I have less than others. So others have more resources, or they consume more, or they have more money than I do. Then in that case, I'm behind relative to others, and I feel this emotion, envy. And second term, compassion, refers to situation where I have more than others. So I consume more than others, and I have more money than others. So in this case, I'm above than relative to others. So in that case, I may feel compassion. So here, these two terms are related to specific kind of inequality. So envy refers to the inequality where I am behind, so others have more than I do. And compassion refers to the inequality where I'm above, so I have more than others. So in this case, FS assume that because of this inequality, individual I has lower utility. So in particular, to be specific, for the NB part, they introduce alpha coefficient. So if this alpha coefficient is bigger, then it means that individual I feels stronger envy. So when he's behind, so others have more than this individual I, in that case, if alpha I is bigger, then individual I's utility will be lower. And we multiply 1 over n minus 1, so I'm going to explain this in a second. And we add terms. This max operator, what does it mean? It means, so there are two numbers here, xj minus xi and 0. So there are two numbers here. So this max operator tells you that If this first number is bigger than 0, then this max operator is going to choose this first number. And if this first number xj minus xi is less than 0, then this max operator is going to choose 0. So for example, so suppose xj is 10 and xi is 2. So this means we are thinking about individual I. So this is individual I's resource. And think about another person, xj. So for example, if I is 2, j is 5, it means that we are thinking about second individual, and consider fifth individual, and this fifth individual has resource 10 units. So in this case, xj minus xi is 8. So this means fifth individual has 8 more resources than individual second individual. And 0, then this max operator returns you this bigger number 8. So here, this notation means we're gonna add up these numbers across all individuals. So for example, suppose n is 3. So here n refers to the total number of individuals in this situation. So if n is 3, there are 3 individuals. And suppose we are thinking about second individual, so I is 2. Then this nv part means minus alpha, so second individual, so alpha 2. So n is 3, so we have 1 over 2 here. And we're gonna add 2 things here for the nv part. So first, suppose j is equal to 1, and second term j is equal to 3. So basically here we are calculating the difference between in the second individual and other individuals. So first individual, second individual, third individual, then here we compare first and second individual, and it comes here, and we compare second individual and third individual, and it comes here. So this second individual is gonna compare what he has with what individual 1 has and individual 3 has. So if second individual compares what he has with the first individual, then xj, so here j is equal to 1. So this is first part, and second part, j is equal to 3. So this is an example of nv part when n is equal to 3. So as you can see, what we do basically here is, so this second individual in this blue term here, this second individual is comparing what he has with what first individual has. And if first individual has more than second individual, then this blue number is gonna be a positive number. Then this max operator is gonna return this positive number. So here we're gonna have x1 minus x2, which is positive number. So for example, this is a positive number. And here, second individual compares what he has with third individual. And suppose third individual has less than second individual, then this blue number is gonna be a negative number. Then this max operator is gonna return zero. So this term is gonna disappear. So this basically means second individual is comparing resources across individuals, and it turns out that first individual has more than second individual. So in this case, second individual feels envy about first individual. And as we saw here in this example, second individual does not feel envy about third individual because second individual has more than third individual. But it is possible that, for example, in another example, if second individual has the least, so first and third individuals have more than second individual, then in that case, we have two terms here. So second individual is gonna feel envy about first individual and third individual. And in this envy part, we have 1 over 2 here, because basically, as we can see, we are adding two terms. So we are adding two terms. So we try to normalize, or in some sense, we are calculating the average in this total envy. So here taking this average is important, because otherwise, suppose, let's say n is 100. So we have 100 individual. So each individual is gonna compare with other 99 individuals in the group. Then here we're gonna add 99 terms, and suppose all these terms are positive, then we are having huge number here. But then in that case, this traditional component of utility is gonna be relatively very small, so it has no predictive power on explaining things. So we don't want it. So that's why when we calculate inequality component, we try to normalize by having this number, and you can understand that basically we are calculating average envy for individual here. So this is envy part, and let's go to compassion part. The other part, beta I, and we normalize. And here we also add so as you can notice here, so if you compare this blue term with the red term here, it's opposite. So now this max operator is gonna give us this number, this blue number. If this blue number is positive, So when this blue number is positive, as you can see, xi is bigger than xj. So that means this max operator is gonna give us some positive number if individual I has more than others. So again, let's think about example here. So again, suppose n is equal to 3. So there are three individual, and let's think about second individual. So this second individual is gonna compare with the first individual and third individual. So here we're gonna add two things. So first here, comparison with the first individual, and second, comparison with the third individual. So comparison with the first individual and comparison with the third individual. And if n is equal to 3, so we have 3 here, so this is gonna be 2. So again, as you can see, we are adding 2 terms here, so we divide by 2. So we are taking average here. So again, so here in this first term, if second individual has more than first individual, then max operator is gonna give us this positive number. Otherwise, it's gonna be zero. And also in the second term, if second individual has more than third individual, then max operator is gonna give us this positive number, or otherwise it's gonna be zero. So as you can easily notice here, if individual 2, so if second individual has more than, for example, first individual, and but less than third individual, then what's gonna happen? So again, using this n equals 3 example, so we have half here. So in this nv part, we only have comparison between second and third individual, because only in that case, second individual feels envy, because second individual does not feel envy about first individual, because second individual has more than first individual. So here we're gonna, have this term here, and here for the compassion part, we're gonna have this this point here, because second individual is gonna feel compassion about first individual. So x2 minus x1. So because each individual has either more or less than others, Each individual is gonna feel either envy or compassion about other individuals. So in this example, when n is equal to 3, second individual feels compassion about first individual. So compassion about first individual appears here. And second individual feels envy about third individual. So this term appears in this NV part. So as you can see here, these non-traditional terms related to inequality appears in individual utility function. In particular, we have minus because of inequality. So in this sense, this model is called inequality aversion. So each individual feels each individual obtains less utility from any type of inequality in the group. So if you think about this envy, this is in some sense disadvantaged type of kind of inequality for this individual, because this individual has less than others. So this is kind of disadvantage. So of course he has utility loss. But for this compassion part, this is inequality, but this is kind of advantageous kind of inequality for this individual, because this individual has more than others. But still, FS assume that this individual has utility loss. So FS model considers this inequality component in individual's utility function. So this is a very important innovation in economic theory. And in particular, FS assume that each individual has lower utility from any kind of inequality. Therefore, the name inequality model of inequality aversion. Okay, so FS model of inequality aversion is in many cases applied to many simple form of games. The most simple form of games is two-player game. So in a game, there are only two players. We already thought about these two-player games, Ultimatum game and Dictator game. So in two-player game case, utility function becomes very simple. So individual I's utility depends on the entire distribution of resource. So here we should have vector x. So traditional component xi minus nv. So here, if there are only two players, then so let's call this individual I and the other individual j. Then this individual I is gonna compare what he has with the other individual j. So this is envy part, and this is compassion part. Because there are only two individuals here, so n is equal to 2, and we know that each individual is gonna feel either envy or compassion about others. We're gonna have only envy left or compassion left. So for example, so there are two individuals. So we are thinking about individual I. So for example, the other individual X, so J, individual J, So consider the other individual has more than individual I. Then in this case, individual I is gonna feel envy about individual J. And you can imagine that the compassion part, the beta part is gonna disappear. And that's very obvious here. So we compare XI, XJ. XJ is bigger. So this number is negative. So this max operator is gonna give us zero. So this term disappears. And here XJ is bigger than XI. So this red number is positive. So this max operator gives us this positive number. So here we have XJ minus XI. So this means if this is the case in this example, individual I's utility can be expressed in this fashion. And as you can see, we only have alpha term, so NV part. So this individual has utility from what he has, so utility from his own consumption. But he has lower utility because of inequality. In particular, in this case, he faces disadvantageous kind of inequality because the other individual J has more than what he has. So individual I is gonna feel envy, and the magnitude of envy depends on this difference between what he has and what the other party has. So the extent of inequality is gonna determine the extent of inequality is gonna determine the utility loss. Okay, so in this case, in this example, so individual I feels envy, and for another case, individual I may feel compassion. So in that case, so individual I feels compassion, then in that case, we have this expression for utility function. So in this case, individual I has more than the other individual. So this is positive. And again, the extent of inequality is gonna determine the utility loss here. And of course, it's gonna be multiplied by beta here and alpha here. So these parameters, alpha and beta, is important. And these alpha and beta can be individual specific because some individual may feel more compassion than others. Then in that case, this beta I is gonna be very big for some individual, but can be very small for others. And if some individual feel great envy, then this alpha I can be a very big number for some people and maybe small number for others. So this alpha and beta parameter does not have to be the same for all individuals. It can be different across individuals. And when we do experiment in reality, it seems that this alpha and beta parameters are quite different across people. So indeed, some people exhibit behavior such that they feel great envy, and others exhibit behavior that show that they feel great compassion. Okay, so this is a two-player game case. So we can use this simple version when we study two-player games such as Ultimatum Game and Dictator Game. But when you want to study a more general game, then in that case, we need a more general version of FS model. Okay, then now we can talk about beta and alpha. Okay, before I talk about that, let's think about drawing graph. So let's draw this utility function and let's see how it looks. So we're gonna draw a utility function of individual I in terms of his own consumption. So we're gonna think about two player case. So there are only two individuals, I and J. So for example, if I is equal to 1, so first individual, then J is going to be equal to 2, and vice versa. So think about two individual situation. And let's think about, so remember in this case, utility function is so alpha I and beta I. So this is a utility function for two individual case. So let's think about how to draw utility function here. So as you learn from microeconomics in undergrad program, so if we draw utility function in this kind of case, so we draw individual's utility function in terms of his own consumption. So in this case, you can draw utility function something like this. So as he consumes more, his utility is increasing. So think about xi as money. So individual I has more money, then his utility is increasing. But we know that marginal utility is diminishing. So as you can see here, slope is getting smaller. So although utility function is increasing here, slope is decreasing, so it shows that marginal utility is diminishing. But here, utility function looks very different. Suppose xj is here. So for example, xj is here. And suppose xi is equal to xj, so we are thinking about this point. So xi is equal to this point, it means that xi is equal to xj. Then as you can see, xi is equal to xj, then all these numbers are zero. So in any case, max operator is gonna give us zero. So all these two inequality terms, envy and compassion, are gonna disappear. So in this case, it's quite straightforward because xi and xj are the same. So there is no inequality here. So individual does not feel any utility laws from inequality. So in this case, the only term remaining in utility function is xi. So xi is equal to xj. So we find this point here. So in this picture, we fix xj and we're gonna vary xi to see how ui, utility function of individual I, looks like. So when xi is equal to xj, we found this point. So when xi is equal to xj, individual I's utility is just equal to xj. Now let's think about blue area. So what do we know about this blue area? So in this blue area, xi is less than xj, because for example, xi is here. Then you can see that in this graph, xi is less than xj. So in this blue area, xi is less than xj. Therefore, this individual I is gonna feel envy. So in other words, in the utility function, only alpha term remains. Then for this green area, we can see that xi is bigger than xj. So individual I has more than the other individual. So he's gonna feel compassion. So we're gonna have only beta term in this green area. Okay, so then, so let's think about blue area first. So let's think about this blue area. So if you think, so when we think about blue area, what's gonna happen? So in blue area, suppose, so moving to the left, so xi goes down. So xi goes down, then first, this term goes down, so individual I has less utility. And moreover, so less utility. And moreover, now here we have inequality, because xi is less than xj in this blue area. So there is inequality appearing here. In particular, individual I is gonna feel envy. So because of this type of inequality, individual I has further utility loss. So we can imagine that utility is gonna decrease here. So as we can see, in this blue area, we can see that individual I's consumption goes up. So xi increases toward xj. As we can see, individual I's utility is increasing. So here, individual I's utility is increasing because of two reasons. As I said, first, his own consumption is increasing, so individual I's utility is increasing. And second, As Xi is increasing toward Xj, this inequality gap is getting smaller. Therefore, inequality is getting smaller, so individual I is having less utility loss. Therefore, individual I's utility is also increasing. So because of these two factors, we can see that in this blue area, utility of individual I is increasing. In particular, in this utility function, if xi is less than xj, we can write down utility function as so beta term disappears, only alpha term remains. So collecting terms and simplify, we have this expression. So as we're gonna see later, alpha parameter is positive number. So this is positive. So we can see that in this graph here. So we can see that this graph has a positive slope. So this is the half of our graph for individual utility function. And now let's think about the other half. So now let's think about the other half of the picture. Now suppose xi goes up. So we're going to think about green area. So now xi goes up. Then first, individual i's utility goes up because as you can see here, his own consumption is increasing. So his utility is increasing. But in this green area, we have inequality. So in this case, xi, his own consumption is bigger than others. So he's gonna feel compassion. So we have only beta term. So because of this inequality, utility goes down. So there are two factors here. Because of first factor, utility is increasing, but because of second factor, utility is decreasing. So in particular, in this case, xi is bigger than xj, then we can write down utility function as, so alpha term disappears, only beta term remains. So this is what we have, so we can rearrange. So if we rearrange this expression, then we get this, So as you can see from this coefficient, when xi goes up, then utility goes up because of increase in his own consumption, but utility goes down because of inequality. So there are two factors here. And as we're gonna see in a second, beta I is less than one. So it seems that beta parameter in general, beta parameter is less than 1, so this is a positive, this is a positive number. So this is a positive number. So, suppose if beta is beta is bigger than 1, this can be negative number. So this can be negative number. So it depends. So it is possible that depending on beta parameter, it is possible that this coefficient is positive or negative. So if this coefficient is positive, we can see that increase in utility function like this. But if it is negative, we can see that decrease in utility function like this. Okay, so this is the graph. This is the graph for individual utility function.